To understand what cryptocurrency is, we first have to understand what money is. And to understand what money is, we have to take a trip back into the early days of human civilization. So buckle up for an adventure through history, as this video will make a crypto noob like you and me into a crypto professional. Hello guys, welcome back to the Curly Genius channel. Today I will explain cryptocurrency using the 5 stages of currency. So stay tuned and watch the whole video. So when society was in its early days, there was no such thing as money. This was stage 1 of currency. The only way to buy or sell something was through exchange, like, hey, I really like your horse, how about I trade you my 3 goats for it? And if both of you agreed, then this was a deal. It stayed this way for hundreds of years, but the stage 1 system of trading had a problem. For example, the person that is selling me the horse might be willing to sell it but not want 3 goats in return. So if there is no other way for me to pay him, then the trade will never happen. So to get rid of this problem, coins were invented. This was the stage 2 of currency. As coins back in the day were made of precious metals like gold and silver, everyone started to use them for trading. So for example, the person can give me the horse and in return I'll give him 10 gold coins instead of 3 goats, so he can do whatever he want with the money. This system also stayed for thousands of years, but it also had a defect. As the coins made of silver and gold were heavy and not easy to carry and store, now stage 3 of currency was established. It was an evolved version of stage 2, and in this stage 3, banks were invented. Banks solved the problem of carrying gold coins and protecting them. Due to banks, you didn't need to keep your gold or silver with you wherever you go. You could just go to your local bank and give them the gold. They would send your data to all its branches and you could take money from any branch of the bank. No more carrying gold coin bags with you or worrying that someone might steal all your gold from your house. This system also introduced paper money. So what is paper money? It is just a receipt from a bank that says that if this person has, for example, a $1 banknote, then the bank has $1 worth of gold or silver in here belonging to him. This system was established a few centuries ago and it is still operational, but the stage 3 system of exchange also has some defects, like how the bank has your money and you only have a receipt of your money. If the banks decide one day to not give you the gold for your banknote, then every bit of banknote you have is useless. The third stage is completely on trust in the government and system. Banknotes are also easier to steal than gold and they are light, compact and easy to destroy. So to battle the problems of stage 3, stage 4 of currency was established. Nowadays we are in stage 4 of currency. In stage 4 you don't have the goats or horses, the coins or the banknotes or anything of your wealth with you physically. In this stage you don't see your money. Your money is stored as a digital spreadsheet and you use your ATM, debit or credit card for getting your money in and out of your bank account. This is currently one of the most convenient and easy stage of currency and exchange in the history of humanity. This stage paved the way for the invention of cryptocurrencies, but it also has some defects, like you still need banknotes, so you use your ATM card to take money out of your ATM to buy and sell stuff. This is not convenient if you don't have an ATM nearby or the ATM breaks, like it always does in Pakistan. And also the security of ATMs is very low, as it only takes a robber to take your PIN and your ATM card to access all your money in seconds. So to battle the problem of stage 4 of currency, cryptocurrencies were invented in the 21st century. They are 100% virtual form of money. They don't have any physical form, which make them the perfect and most convenient form of exchange for a few reasons. You cannot physically see, touch, smell or eat them. I don't know if you would like to eat your crypto, but we move on nonetheless. And it also has many advantages over the banking system. Here are some of the features and advantages of cryptocurrency. It is a completely virtual entity, means you can carry millions of crypto coins in a small memory drive. It is more secure than bank money and ATMs, as it uses blockchain technology to provide security. It is more environmentally friendly, so we don't have to cut trees or mine minerals for making coins or banknotes. It removes the government taxes and limitations on money, and banks take a share of your money every time you make a transaction, and some banks even use your money for their own purposes, as you do not need all your money at once and it is kept in the bank. While cryptocurrencies take a very small part of your transactions and nobody And I mean nobody except you can use your money as it is secured by the blockchain. All these advantages make cryptocurrencies like Bitcoin, Ethereum and Dogecoin extremely secure, and that's why crypto is called the future of currency. So a quick recap of the video is, cryptocurrency is just a code generated by a computer that is unique and uncrackable. It has no physical form, so no one can steal it easily as it has blockchain technology. From this recap, there must be some question in your mind, like what is blockchain technology? Can you really steal cryptocurrencies? So if cryptocurrencies are useful and amazing, then why are people afraid of it? Should I invest in crypto? What are the defects of cryptocurrencies? Those are my topics for the upcoming month. So subscribe so you don't miss out. My laptop can only edit a video up to 5 minutes. So goodbye. Love you all. And I hope you have understood the concept of cryptocurrency a little more. Subscribe and peace.